There are many types of gears such as spur gears, helical gears, worm gears, etc. This can be generally classified by looking at the positions of axes such as parallel shafts, intersecting shafts and non-intersecting shafts. In this video, we will learn about different types of gears used to transmit power from one shaft to another shaft. There are commonly 7 types. 1. Spur gear. 2. Helical gear. 3. Herringbone gear. 4. Bevel gear. 5. Worm gear. 6. Rack and pinion gear. 7. Internal gear. Spur gear. Parallel and co-parallel shafts connected by gears are called spur gears. Spur gears have straight teeth and are parallel to the axis of wheel. Spur gears are the most common type of gears. The advantages of spur gears are their simplicity in design, economy of manufacture and maintenance. Spur gears are known as slow speed gears. If noise is not a serious design problem, spur gears can be used at almost any speed. Helical gear. Helical or dry fixed gears offer a refinement over spur gears. The leading edges of the teeth are not parallel to the axis of rotation, but are set at an angle. Since the gear is curved, this angling makes the teeth shaped a segment of helix. Helical gears can be meshed in parallel or crossed orientations. Herringbone gear. Herringbone gears resemble two helical gears that have been placed side by side. They are often referred to as double helicals. In double helical gears arrangement, the thrusts are counterbalanced. In such double helical gears, there is no thrust loading on the bearings. Bevel gear. Bevel gears are gears where the axis of the two shafts intersect and the tooth bearing faces of the gears themselves are conically shaped. Bevel gears are most often mounted on shafts that are 90 degrees apart, but can be designed to work at other angles as well. The pitch surface of bevel gears is a cone. Worm gear. Worm gears are used to transmit power at 90 degrees and where high reduction are required. The axis of worm gear shafts cross in space. The shafts of worm gears lie in parallel planes and may be skewed at any angle between 0 and right angle. In worm gears, one gear has screw threads. Due to this, worm gears are quite vibration-free and give a smooth output. Worm gears and worm gear shafts are almost invariably at right angles. Rack and pinion gear. A rack is a toothed burr or rod that can be thought of as a sector gear with an infinitely large radius of curvature. Torque can be converted to linear force by meshing a rack with a pinion. The pinion turns. The rack moves in a straight line. Such a mechanism is used in automobiles to convert the rotation of the steering wheel into the left to right motion of the tie rods. Internal gear. Internal gear is a gear with its teeth cut in the internal surface of a cylinder and meshes with spur gears. In its manufacturing, because of its shape, the usual hobbing machine used in spur gear production cannot be used. Dear sir, thanks for watching the video. For more updates, please subscribe to our channel, Learning Engineering, and get notification to press the bell icon.